so many hours put in at the track. So Australia goes home with a bronze medal. Very, very bad luck for the New Zealanders.
So silver in 2016 for Australia, now bronze. The last bronze medal was in 1996.
Now, a quick explanation of what happened yesterday when the Danish riders ran into Great Britain on the track. The official cause was that a flag wasn't risen by the commissaires to let them know that the team had been split up, the team of Great Britain. Therefore, Denmark did not know there was a rider dropped off the two leaders.
The race for the gold medal in the men's team pursuit. Denmark, the world champions, against Italy. For the first time in four Olympic Games, Great Britain are not involved here. And it's a battle between these two powerhouse combinations. The world record has been shattered by both combinations. This is going to be a race to savor for Italy. Consonni, Ganna, Lamon and Milan. For Denmark, Hansen, Larsen, Madsen and Pedersen.
So much experience in both teams. Denmark was up for the first lap. Now Italy is up. It's going to be a closely contested race between the Italians and Denmark.
Both have won Olympic gold before, but not for many, many years. Denmark in 1968. And the last time Italy took gold was in 1960. So in Rome, that is a long time ago. So glory beckons.
Well, the Italians have taken a handy lead at this point. They're 0.3 of a second up on the Italian team, so there's not much in it. The Danish team, should I say. Italy leads by 0.2 of a second.
Simone Milan for Italy, Niklas Larsen for the Danish quartet.
So there's nothing in it at the moment. The Italians slightly ahead of the Danish team, as we just see the onboard camera of Jonathan Milan.
Italy will look to the world time trial champion on the road, Filippo Ganna, to bring the power late in the race. Lasse Norman Hansen, the Omnium gold medalist in 2012, is in the Danish combination. They will bring the power. Ganna on the front for Italy now. It's early days yet.
Yep, 0.1 of a second.
So tight still. It's Filippo Ganna, the big man. He's 1.93 meters tall. Puts on the power.
Well, there's the Italian coach, and they're still leading just ever so slightly over the team of Denmark. It's so close. The Italians, the Danish team.
Eventually, he swings off, and Francesco Lamon takes over for Italy. Denmark 0-3-1 down. Not much in it. Very, very little.
Denmark in the lead now. This is where it is getting very, very close. Denmark have come back. They've taken the lead from Italy, and they look to be doing it in pretty fine form.
They're down to three riders now with Niklas Larsen on the front for Denmark. They're driving it on, and Italy have got pressure now to bring it back. They've lost Francesco Lamon.
Well, they're half a second down now, the Italians, just like that. The Danish team have brought it back in fine form. And this will be shocking for the Italians. They're losing more and more time, the Italians, at this point, 0.8 of a second.
1,000 metres to go, and it's Denmark who have the gold in their hands at the moment. Italy having to dig so deep. Filippo Ganna having to do the work on the front, and he pulls off now.
Well, if he's pulled off now, he won't have time to bring back this gap. I don't think he's got to pull one big last turn. There's 0.7 of a second in this. 0.6 now. It's very close. Denmark still has the lead. Lasse Norman Hansen on the front. It's now Italy trying to bring it back.
Frederik Madsen, the man who crashed in the semi-final, now is bringing it home for Denmark. The gap is coming down, though. 0.387. Italy are digging deep. There's the bell now. We're in for a thrilling final lap now. Italy going to push hard here. They've done it in the previous rounds. It is going to be Italy who are going to push hard, but are they going to bring it enough as Denmark are looking to win their first gold medal since 1968? It's so close. It's Italy. So close, and Italy take it. They have taken it in sensational fashion with a world record.
Yeah, I could see that coming back just in the last lap. The Italians were only slightly ever so much behind. And in the last half a lap, they have taken the win. And you can see the Italian staff and crowd. They are absolutely delighted. A long time coming for the Italian team.
Well, it's their eighth win in the team pursuit. Look at this man, Filippo Ganna. He had it turned on. And my word, did he put in a power ride. The Italian squad were superb. And they looked to that man when they needed him most, and he delivered in emphatic fashion.
Look at the Italians. They're in tears. They're in tears. They can't believe this. So many years. Filippo Ganna, he raises that beautiful bike we've been talking about. The fastest bike here at the track in Tokyo Olympic pursuit.
Simone Consonni, Filippo Ganna, Francesco Lamon and Jonathan Milan are the Olympic champions. And it is some 61 years since Luigi Arrienta, Franca Testa, Mario Valotto and Marino Vigna were the last gold medalists for Italy. Italy have done a magnificent job today, leaving it till the very last lap. And they pulled it out the hat. Absolutely extraordinary.
Oh, they can't believe it, the Italians. Look at them celebrating.
What a ride. Look at him. He stands tall above them all, doesn't he? And they all did their part in putting Ganna in position to be able to execute on that final lap. And they did it in the previous round as well, as I saw off New Zealand. But this was quite special.
We've been talking about the Italians. You and I, we both put our money on the Italians for the win today. There was just something about them from day zero, seeing them in the training, how focused they've been. And you can just see there how delighted they are. A gold medal at the Olympics. It's been so long since we've seen Italy at the top. There's been so much work put in to their training preparation. And there's the women's team's pursuit team, Barbieri, Letizia Paternoster, celebrating the win with the amazing bikes from Pinarello, beautiful blue, and Filippo Ganna.
Well, the next time they ride those in a team pursuit, they might be in gold, because they certainly deserve it. What a performance.
They are still celebrating like mad. And what a morale lift too for Viviani, who's with the team right now, getting ready for his events, shaking the hands of all the Italian riders. Dino Salvadelli, the coach.
The men's team pursuit, Italy in the gold medal position, an enthralling, thrilling final over Denmark, with Australia taking the bronze medal, beating New Zealand as they passed them. And then Canada, Germany, Great Britain and Switzerland.
Mesdames et messieurs, la cérémonie des vainqueurs de cyclisme sur piste, poursuite par équipe, hommes.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony for the cycling track men's team pursuit.
皆様、ただいまより。
Well, the team pursuit has delivered incredible drama and just the most amazing racing, and worthy champions in this Olympic cycle, and new champions as well, as the medalists. Well, it's wonderful that they're paraded through the center of the track to the appreciation of the other riders all round, because the final delivered a race for the ages. It really was one of the most enthralling and thrilling battles we've seen on the track for many, many years. Australia fought back after the drama of their early rounds, when Alexander Porter's bars broke, and they fought back to post the time fast enough to get them into the bronze medal round. And Italy and Denmark, well, they have been quite extraordinary. Denmark, the drama of their semi-final when they had a rider, Fredrik Madsen, crash into Charlie Tanfield. And Italy have been imperious.
The medals will be presented by
Medaille Nozoteva.
Madame Sarah Walker, membre du CIO Nouvelle-Zélande, Olympienne, une médaille d'argent.
IOC member, New Zealand, Olympian, one silver medal.
That came in the BMX in London in 2012 for Sarah Walker.
Olympian, gold medal one.
Accompanied by
続きまして,
Monsieur David Lapartien, President de l'UCI France.
UCI President France.
国際自転車競技連合会長フランス.
UCI President David Lapartien will accompany Sarah Walker.
Bronze medalists. Australia!
Gold medalist, Australia!
Well, there were silver medalists in Rio in 2016.
Lee Howard.
The oldest member of the team, Lee Howard.
Tom O'Brien. Lucas Plapp. Sam Welsford.
So, Howard, O'Brien, Plapp, and Welsford. Bronze medalists at the Olympic Games, keeping a strong tradition of being medalists at the Games and redeeming themselves after a disappointing World Championships.
Silver medalists, Denmark.
Well, they're the world champions, and it took a world record performance to beat them. The Omnium gold medalist from 2012, Lasse Norman Hansen.
Fredrik Madsen. Rasmus Pedersen.
They were trying to become only the second Danish team to win a gold medal in this event back in 1968 in Mexico City. Gunnar Asmussen, Mogens Jensen, Per Langenmark, and Rene Olsen were the gold medalists there. But it wasn't to be.
Medaille d'or et champion olympique, Italy.
Gold medalists.
In a performance of the highest order, in a race for the ages, Italy are the Olympic champions in Tokyo.
Simone Consonni, Filippo Ganna, Francesco Lamon, Jonathan Milan.
61 years after they last won gold through Luigi Arienti, Franca Testa, Mario Valotto, and Marino Vigne, the Italian anthem will be heard thanks to Simone Consonni, Filippo Ganna, Francesco Lamon, and Jonathan Milan in a world record performance.
Italy.
皆様, Italia 国家の演奏です。
Thank you. wonderful. Their teammates in the stands and in the center of the track singing along.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Olympic medalists.
Italy, the gold medalists in the men's team pursuit, in a world record time in the final to beat Denmark. Australia take the bronze medal as they beat New Zealand.